both of you, Admiral and Elliot, use the word imagine, imagination, imagining the future. And I know in previous interviews, I've been reading your other interviews, you said that you started out at a much later date, but then events brought you back. So
what date did you start?
Where did you start out? How did you come to 2034?
And part two of that question is
you mentioned also that events overtook your draft.
You had to add in the pandemic in really nuanced ways, but how much did you feel like you had to add in things that were happening that you didn't even expect to happen?
So part one, what year did you start off with? How did you get to 2024, and then what did you feel you had to add in from 2020?
Yeah, I think we started with the dates sort of always in pencil in the early drafts. But it was out there. I mean, it was, could be to like 2050s, you know, we were just, I think when you're writing a book, you know, the book kind of has to tell you its mood when it's taking place. But what very quickly became clear to us was, you know, the date was almost like a tide coming up a beach, and it kept getting like closer and closer to our toes until we had sort of been talking about the date so much that we realized the date was going to be the title of the book. And that actually occurred pretty late in the process when we figured that out. But you know, with regards to your comment on present events overtaking the narrative, I mean, that's certainly happened. Probably the most obvious one was the coronavirus. Another one I remember very specifically was over Christmas of 2019-20, that kind of winter period, was when Qasem Soleimani was killed. Yeah. And we had earlier drafts that had the character Farshad had a different backstory with Qasem Soleimani. So I remember, you know, opening up my phone the next morning. I can't remember who called whom, but we were both like, God, we're going to have to rethink all of this and how it features into the book. But I think that's also, you know, the joy of writing a book is it forces you to kind of reimagine the narrative. And so much of this book has been, listen, if there is a year where we have gone back and said, like, I can't imagine. I don't think any of us have said as much as we said it this past year with the pandemic. And I think if you look at the pandemic is one of the great catastrophes that America has been through in the last 7,500 years. I think you could say 9/11 was another catastrophe that we endured, you know, and Pearl Harbor attack, for instance. You know, all three of those were things where the postmortem was these were failures of imagination. And the spirit of this book is okay, let's go ahead and let's try to imagine what can happen next as a way of inoculating ourselves from it. Because I think at this point, you might be able to say that, you know, imagination has become a national security imperative. You know, we need to be projecting out what some of these catastrophes might be just to improve our readiness.
Yeah, let me add to that if you put a marker in your mind that 10 to 15 years from now, the trend lines are driving us toward a war with China, I think that is inarguable. Then it becomes possible to reverse engineer it back to the present and say, okay, what led us there? You don't wake up in 2034 and go to war with China. There are a series of discrete things that happen that we could debate about in foreign policy circles. Will Taiwan fall to China in a military invasion in the next 5 to 7 years? That was just testified to by the current 4-star admiral commander of the Indo-Pacific Command without any qualification. He simply said, you know, I think this could happen in the next 6 years. This is Admiral Phil Davidson, who commands all U.S. forces in the Pacific, and newsflash, is reading the highest level intelligence that anybody has access to. His relief, who is testifying in front of Congress to get the job, said two days ago that a military move against Taiwan is much closer than people think, unquote. This is real, folks.
And it doesn't mean that we have to just stumble along and accept all these bad outcomes, but it does mean we have to think consciously about the far end of the spectrum, reverse engineer our way back, and avoid it. That's the essence of 2034.